You shouldn't miss this video because today we take a closer look how you can make a lot of profit out of your hideout in Escape from Tarkov. Dear comrades, Ivan the German is back for you guys, and today we take a closer look about making some profit out of your hideout in Escape from Tarkov. And almost every item can be useful if you use your hideout correctly. So let's jump right into the hideout. So first things first, what should you do in your hideout? I would say go for the workbench level 2 and for the lavatory level 2 or level 3. Why should you go for the workbench? And that's very simple, because very early on you can make some profitable stuff. Especially if you're looking for some ammunition, what you can craft, especially the AP slugs. The AP slugs can be sold for about 1,100 ruble in the early and early mid state of the wipe. Right now you can see it's still going for 960 and it's going up to 1,000 ruble per shotgun shell. So that's okay for this trade. Furthermore, you can craft some AP rounds if you want to, but it costs 2 red gunpowder. I would recommend, and that's a tip for the next wipe, buy the OFZ shells very early on, because right now they are very expensive. As you can see right here, 100,000 ruble for one shell is quite a lot, because every one of them is making the trade, because you can make very, very strong ammunition and trades and workbench crafts with the OFZ shells, as you can see here. So for example, 2 shells and 2 green gunpowder are 300 rounds M995 for your M4 or for your ADA, which is quite a lot, and this is quite expensive, because as you can see here, one round is sold for 1380 ruble. And that's the thing, what I said in the first basic video about some experience in Tarkov and how you can make money for the next wipe. You can use this information and buy the OFC shells very, very early on. They are very, very cheap and you can stash a lot of them. So for the next trade is the MCB, because right now, if you have some items not found in raid, like the CPU, like some capacitors, they are all worth around 20k. You can sell them directly because they are one slot items, or you can use it for the MCB and you can craft the military circuit board. You need 2 hours to craft it and you can sell it for 150,000 ruble. So comrade, wait for a second, I guess you're new to this channel. If you want to be a better gamer and if you want to improve your own game experience, subscribe to this channel. We are going to help you with our videos and you shouldn't miss them anymore. Furthermore, you can continue. 1 blue gunpowder, 1 green gunpowder, and 1 classic matches is 2 red gunpowder. This is useful if you can't sell, or if you don't want to sell your blue gunpowder or your green gunpowder. And the classic matches are also worth 13k. You can sell them straight on. They can go up to 20k. Or you can use the matches to make this craft for 2 red gunpowder. And you need the red gunpowder to make some more bullets, like, as I said, the 9mm or the AP slugs. Furthermore, this craft with the 7 and 31 is also very interesting, because right now the ingredients are very expensive. Even the nails are right now worth around 30k, and this is a great information for you guys, because it's a one slot item, as I said, and you can make tons of money. So this video is also a little bit about which items you should keep, and the flat screwdriver is always valuable. Like I said, it's a one slot item and you can sell it for 70k, or you keep it and make some crafts out of it. Let's continue. Early on, you get a lot of power cords and you can use this 2 power cords to make 8 wires. You can sell wires early on for 20 to 25 to 30k, which is very worth if you find 2 power cords and you won't sell them or you won't use it. A new crafting option in your workbench with Tarkov 12.9 is the FLIR rifle scope. It's a thermal and you can craft it with a lot of ingredients. And in my opinion, it's not worth to craft, because the ingredients are very expensive, like the 2 military vision modules are worth 150k, the vertex is worth around 150k, and the thermal scope in the end is only worth 390k. And it's a little bit sad, because thermals, in my opinion, are very strong, maybe a little bit too strong, but they will bring a new stim. We will talk about that later on. But thermal, as I said, in the mid and early wipe is very powerful. And yeah, if you have some ingredients laying around which are not found in raid, you can use this craft, but I wouldn't recommend it. But furthermore, with like 4 wires and 1 red gunpowder, you can craft 180 rounds of RIP ammunition. Right now, the RIP ammunition dropped a little bit, 720 ruble, but you can sell it for 1000 or 900 ruble very early on, and 9mm RIP ammunition is very powerful and very strong. A very good craft to level up your skill, or if you need some magnets for some other crafts, is the HDD to magnet. You can get the HDD for like 8,000 to 10,000 ruble, and you can craft one magnet, which is worth around 15 to 30k, depends on the status of the wipe. And if you have some metal fuel tanks out of your generator and some blue gunpowder, you can craft 120 shot flat shell ammunition for your shotgun. It's not worth that much, but in my opinion, the flechette ammunition is very strong. And if you're running a generator, of course, you will have some metal fuel tanks, so why not use them? A very powerful craft is the green gunpowder out of two hand grenades, M67, which can be bought from Peacekeeper. This will cost you $80, which are around 10,000 ruble. And you need one smoke grenade for 5,000 ruble, and you can get like one green gunpowder, which is awesome. You can use this green gunpowder for your other crafts, or you can sell it directly. There is a mission where you need like the M67 grenades. You can buy them directly from Peacekeeper, or you can sell if you have some M67 hand grenades found in raid. You can loot them very often from stashes, from hidden stashes, for 40 to 80k early and mid early in the wipe. So I would sell them straight on for 40 or 80k, everything in between. Sell them straight away. This is a lot of money you can make. The two green gunpowder and the one blue gunpowder craft for 260 rounds of 7.62 BP is also not that bad. Keep that in mind that you can do this craft. It really depends on the BP price. You should check the prices all the time. And if you can sell BP for 950 to 1050 ruble, you should do this craft. So furthermore, the lavatory. The lavatory is also very good to make some profit, even early on, because you can make a lot of very good crafts. They added a very new craft to the lavatory, and you can make some keg tape. You need the keg tape for the 60 round AK magazines, for quests, and for the lucky scav box. That's why the keg tape is very expensive. As you can see, the price dropped a little bit from 65k to 45k. Which is nice if you want to buy the keg tape immediately, or you need it found in raid, or you have the ingredients for the keg tape. And the ingredients are very easy to get. And the clean wiper is also a new craft out of one vodka and one shampoo. Vodka is sold directly to therapists for 15k, shampoo depends on the price on the market, and you can get the clean wiper. So the ingredients for the keg tape are easy to get. One wiper, two insulating tape, and two duct tapes. You can sell the insulating tape early on for 30k, because you need them for the barter to get your tool set, which is also very expensive because you need a lot of them. So you should keep that in mind, that you need the blue duct tape. And the normal duct tape is also sold for 10 to 20k, but right now it's very cheap and very easy to make the keg tape craft. So, and if you have the keg tape, as you can see here, you can craft your lucky scav box, or you can craft your magazines. And you need the magazines for quests and for gunsmith parts. I wouldn't craft the FP100 filter, because you can sell the water filter in the mid and late wipe for about 100,000 rubles, because you need a water filter for your purified water, and you can sell one purified water for 100 or 150,000 rubles. And that's why this trade isn't useful. You can buy the FP100 filter straight from the market. You should be cheaper. Furthermore, also very interesting is the new security vest, because this vest is worth up to 40,000 rubles, so increase a little bit, because you need three of them to craft some Cordura. And the Cordura is very useful, especially mid and late wipe, because you need them for some barter trades to get some good ammunition. So if you find some security vests and you can stash them, you should take them with you, because they are worth 40,000 rubles, and you can either sell it to the flea market, or you can craft some Cordura, depends on what you want. Furthermore, one soap, one alkali, and one sodium are 5 bleaches, and some bleach and some shampoo. I guess it was 3 bleach and 2 shampoo. It's a barter to get the TV rig. Especially early on, this craft with 1 tube, 3 wires, and 3 tapes is very handy, because you can craft 2 hoses, and you need a lot of hoses. Either you want to sell them or you want to keep them. So this craft is very powerful. You should keep that in mind. The magazine case trade is also very interesting, because with 3 magazine cases and some other ingredients, you can make your lucky scav box. But be aware, bolts are very expensive, 50 to 60k. Furthermore, get some fuel from quests. Metal scissors are also a bit cheaper this wipe, 30k. As I said, you can invest into 3 magazine cases to craft your lucky scav box, and you can sell the lucky scav box for around 2 million. So consider to make this trade. And furthermore, the editor grenade case craft. So the workbench and the lavatory can be used to make some passive income every couple hours. The next, the Intelligence Center, is a little bit different because your crafts from the Intelligence Center take a while. As you can see, I'm crafting some quest items right here, but especially the GPU craft is insane because you need one VPX, which is sold from 200 to 300k, some other ingredients which are cheaper, and you can get a GPU out of this craft, which is sold for right now 800k, which is way too overpriced, but you can use this craft. It takes you 54 hours to get the GPU, but it's worth because it's passive, you don't have to do anything. So the intelligence craft is very powerful. I would run this all the time if I do not need any items or the GPUs, because you need 3 flash drives and 1 paper. The paper is new, but the paper is cheap, and you can get 1 intelligence out of it. So flash drive is 30-40k each, and paper is also very cheap, 10k, and you get this intelligence, which is very valuable. 250k, you need a lot of the intelligence for your hideout or for your for the scav case, so this one is very good. Furthermore, you get a lot of SSDs and some other stuff, and you can craft 3 flash drives out of this craft. So depends on what you want to do. It's like you can craft this flash drives or you can buy them from the market. So the VPX craft is also very handy because the ingredients are cheap. It takes a while to make this, but you get 2 VPX out of this craft. Even this VPX is also very valuable, or you can use the VPX, as I said in the beginning, to craft the GPU. So the Violet Keycard craft is new with 12.9. I wouldn't craft it because it's not worth. You need 3 yellow keycards, 12 normal keycards for labs, and 7 intelligence, and for the price of 4 million for the Violet Keycard straight away, it's right now not worth crafting. But you should consider to craft the 11SR for interchange, and you need the 21WS, which is expensive for 1 million, but you can use it. As I said in the other video about the new crafts, you can use it 14 times, and after that you can make the new keycard, which will have again all 15 uses. Or of course you can sell it for 2 million. Let's continue with the famous Bitcoin farm. As you can see here, I only have 6 GPUs because I sold almost every GPU which is found in raid or which I crafted. So if you like the passive income, the peak of effectiveness with your Bitcoin farm is if you stash in 10 graphics cards. Every other graphics card which is found in raid, I would sell it because they are way too overpriced right now with 700 to 800k. Maybe they rise a little bit, but if you have more than 10 in your Bitcoin farm, just sell them. If you have them found in raid, if not, just stash it in your Bitcoin farm. So for the generator, as you can see here, I stash different fuel tanks because even if they are empty, you can use them as ingredients for your parts. The water collector is expensive to get it on level 3, but if you have it on level 3, you can use your water filter to craft some purified water. So, and if you have the purified water, you can sell it for 150k, you can make some moonshine out of it, or we can continue to the nutrition unit. So, and with 1 purified water and 1 tube, you get 8 aquamary, but in my opinion, it's not worth to make this. You can buy it directly, or you find a lot of these items. But with the nutrition unit, you can make some very interesting things for your quests very early on. You need 15 can of beef stew, which is the Tushonka, and you need 1 big can of beef stew, 1 squash and 1 croutons. And these ingredients are very expensive, especially early on. But if you have these items, you can make your Tushonka. And that's why these things are even right now very expensive, because you need them for the quest. And you need squash for some barter trades. And that's why this item is still very valuable for a 1 slot item. And food in general is very expensive. That's why I would run on woods right now, because with the wood expansion, you can make a lot of money. Croutons are only worth 25 to 30k because of the fee if you want to sell it on the flea. Sugar is also very cheap right now. It will raise to 70k, and you can loot a lot right on woods. Let's check some other stuff. Even the Iskra lunchbox is worth 20k for a 2 slot item. Milk, which is a 1 slot item, 50k if you sell it straight to the vendor. Spreads also 15k. The herring is also very valuable for 1 slot item because you need it for the barter trade. And we can continue with some drinks. Water is a little bit cheap right now, but the whiskey, 45k. And where is it? Like the Tara Cola is 22 to 25k. And you can find a lot of these things on woods straight away. Furthermore, with 2 chocolate, you can craft 1 sugar. And right now, chocolate, even in this status of the wipe, chocolate is very expensive. As I said, sugar is very cheap, because right now, if you have chocolate which is not found in raid, you can make this craft, but right now it's not worth to sell sugar straight away. Just keep the sugar and wait till it's more valuable. And if you want to go for the Kiba key, you need 60 condensed milk. That's why you can use, right now it's the best time, use milk for 18k and sugar to craft 3 condensed milk, but as I said, on Woods you get a lot of it. So, the med station. The med station is also very interesting, because you get a lot of these ingredients everywhere in almost every raid. The Devi is very interesting, you need this for a quest. Also, you can craft it, as you can see it right here. The ingredients can be very cheap if you find them or if you craft them, and you can sell the Devi for about 130 to 150k. It depends on the status of the wipe. Or you can sell it straight away, or you can use it, as I said, for your quest right now. Also, you can, if you have some toolboxes, you can make the FP100 filter. I wouldn't recommend that. And if you have some tool sets which you do not need anymore, you can craft 2 survival kits, which is right now they're a little bit cheap, but you can sell them for around 30k, and I will wait till you can sell it for 30 to 35k. Furthermore, you can craft 2 IFACs. You can use IFAC right now, and it's brand new, to stop heavy bleeding, but it's very expensive for your IFAC. I guess it was 190 or 290 to stop heavy bleeding. You need 2 pile of meds, 2 bandages, and these ingredients are very cheap. You get 2 IFACs out of it. Furthermore, Probital. In my opinion, Probital is way too underrated. It's only worth 15k. I would buy them and use them all the time, and you can craft it. So what you can do, if you fight some golden star which is not found in raid, use the golden star for your normal raids till you have 1 use left, and after that, make this craft. 7 Probital is great, I would use it all the time if you can. So, and this is the best price per effectiveness for some painkillers. If you have the ingredients for the SJ6, right now is the time, because the SJ6 is getting more and more value to you, so consider to making this craft, because the saline lution is right now very cheap. Early and mid early in the wipe, it's more expensive. So, and this one is the brand new item, it's the antidote to fix the unknown poison from the cultists. And the antidote, as you can see here, is not that cheap. So a lot of these crafts in the med stations aren't profitable in the first place. But if you have some items laying around and you can't sell them, or you won't sell them on the flea, you can use the craft to make a little bit value out of it. Like the pile of meds, 5 of them is 1 grizzly. As you can see, the grizzly isn't worth that much, but you can use the grizzly because it's not that bad, or you're selling the pile of meds straight away, or use them for something else. But as I said, straight profit out of the med station is a bit difficult. Maybe early on the blood sets are also worth 50 to 60 to 70k and ingredients aren't a bit cheaper, but right now it's a little bit hard to make some profit out of this. So we have 2 things left. The first thing is the boost generator. Right now I'm not interested in crafting the boost generator. I'm not going for the scav cases in this wipe. I will craft the boost generator later on. I know I have the money to craft it, but I'm not interested in it, because the scav case and the boost generator are very expensive, as you can see here. 1 roller is worth 300,000 rubles and the other stuff is also a bit, and in my opinion the scav case disappointed me too much to craft it. Yes, I have the money, as I said, but I'm not interested in the scav case anymore. I will show you a video with 100 moonshine and intelligence runs, and as I said, I'm very unlucky with the scav case runs, but a friend of mine, Ole Brolo, he got some key cards and all the stuff all the time, some keys, so for him it's very valuable. So it depends on you if you want to go for the scav case. I'm not interested in, but I will show you the option, and that's it for the hideout. But in my opinion, you are making a lot of money with this corner of the hideout over here. The workbench, especially if you have it on 2 or 3, and the lavatory on 2 or 3. The intelligence center is very profitable, and it's also passive income like the Bitcoin farm. So these 4 things, especially workbench level 2 with the AP rounds and the AP slugs and the BP rounds. I'm going for the AP rounds almost all the time. It's worth a lot. So that's for the hideout. The hideout is very handy if you use it correctly in the current time, but that's with all of the options BSG gives you in Tarkov to make some money out of it. So if you're interested in more item stuff, items to keep in which week and all of the stuff about the money, let me know what you think into the comments below. This video is longer than I thought. And guys, don't forget, if you like the video, show the world that we Germans can do at least something. And if you like, I would appreciate it that we can show it to the world out there. See you in the next video, guys. Bye.